Hello friends, welcome to TalentSprint. Today we are here to discuss the monthly current affairs from the month of September. So let's start with the first question on your screen now. Who was appointed as the next Indian ambassador to Norway, replacing Krishnan Kumar? And the answer is, it's B. Bal Bhaskar. So who is the Prime Minister of Norway? It's Erna Solberg. And what is the capital of Norway? It's Oslo. And currency is krone. Which city hosted the United Nations 2019 Ocean Conference? And the answer here is, it has been hosted by Malay of Maldives. And 2020 Ocean Conference will be hosted by Lisbon. So Malay is the capital of Maldives. And what is the currency of Maldives? It's Maldivian rupiah. Now the next question. Where was the first ever mobile science exhibition was flagged off by Union Culture and Tourism Minister Sri Prahlad Singh Patel? Center has launched the updated Credit Linked Capital Subsidy Scheme, that is CLCSS, for the micro, small, medium enterprises. Under this update scheme, the SCST entrepreneurs will be given additional subsidies of dash percentage on institutional credit of up to 1 crore. And the answer here is, it's 10%. Now the next, the Multi-Commodity Exchange of India has recently signed a memorandum of understanding with which country's commodity exchange for cooperation and the exchange of information. And the answer here is, it has been signed memorandum of understanding with Zhengzhou Commodity Exchange. So who is the managing director and CEO of Multi Commodity Exchange of India? It's P.S. Reddy. And chairperson is Saurabh Chandra. Now the next question. Anupama Swain has recently won a bronze medal for India to directly enter the 2022 Asian Games. And she represents which sports? And the answer here is, she represents martial arts. And she is the only Indian to participate in this championship. And this event was held in Chungu of South Korea. So what's the capital of South Korea? It's Seoul. And currency is Korean won. And after qualifying this, he has been qualified for 2022 Asian Games. Now the next question. The World Health Organization Southeast Asia region is committed to eliminate the measles and rubella by which year? And the answer here is, they have committed to eliminate measles and rubella by 2023. So where is the headquarter of WHO? It's in Geneva of Switzerland. Who is the head of WHO? Tedros Adhanom. And who is the regional director of WHO Southeast Asia? It's Poonam Khetrapal Singh. Now the next question. Which edition of the India-Thailand Coordinated Patrol 2019 is being held in Bangkok? And the answer here is, it's 28th edition. Robert Gabriel Mugabe passed away in Singapore due to health issues. And he was former president of which country? And he was the former president of Zimbabwe. So what's the capital of Zimbabwe? Harare. And who is the current president of Zimbabwe? It's Emmerson Mnangagwa. He is the current president of Zimbabwe. Now the next question. Kiran Nagarkar died in Mumbai on 5th September at the age of 77. He was a dash and he was a novelist and playwright. Now the next question, on which day India celebrates Teachers Day to mark the birth anniversary of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan? And the answer here is, it's 5th September. Now the next question, Dash selected for setting up of a sophisticated analytical and technical help institute, that is abbreviated as SATHI, a development of science and technology initiative of the center, for which rupees 125 crore has been earmarked over a period of 3 years. And the answer here is, it's IIT Kharagpur. Now the next question. ECL Finance, a subsidiary of Edelweiss Financial Services, have signed a co-originated agreement with which bank to increase access to credit for micro, small, medium enterprises? And the answer here is, it's State Bank of India. Who is the chairperson of State Bank of India? It's Rajnish Kumar. Now the next question. How many public sector banks are authorized to provide loans under PSB loans in 59 minutes web portal? And the answer here is, it's 19. Now the next question. Which state police department has recently launched a mobile app named C-Plan to curb anti-social activities in the state with a police-public partnership? And the answer here is, it has been introduced in Uttar Pradesh. So what's the capital of Uttar Pradesh? It's Lucknow. And who is the chief minister? It's Yogi Adityanath. And governor is Anandiben Patel. Which state has recently signed a sister state memorandum of understanding with the Delaware state of America to boost ties? And the answer here is, it's Gujarat. And this is the first sister state memorandum of understanding signed by Gujarat with any state of America. And who is the chief minister of Gujarat? It's V. Rupani. And governor is Acharya Devavrat. Now the next question. The Vatican has honored Nobel laureate Professor Muhammad Yunus with the Lamp of Peace of Saint Francis Award. And he belongs to which country? And he belongs to Bangladesh. So what's the capital of Bangladesh? It's Dhaka. And currency is Taka. And who is the Prime Minister? Sheikh Hasina. And President is Abdul Hamid. And this has been awarded for the contribution in peace and harmony. So the next question. On which day, International Day of Charity, is celebrated to commemorate the death anniversary of Mother Teresa? And the answer here is, it is celebrated on September 5th. Now the next question. India ranks 9th in the list of top 10 countries in terms of total gold reserves with 618.2 tons. And which of the following country has topped the list? And it has been topped by USA. And this is the first time India has surpassed Netherlands to move to the top 10 countries in terms of gold reservation. So according to this World Gold Council, the US leads the country with the total gold reserves of 8,133.5 tons. And it has followed by Germany, which has reserved 3,366.8 tons. Now the next question. Which of the following adjudges as the best Swachh iconic place in the country in the Swachh iconic place list released by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, Department of Drinking Water and Sanitation? And the answer here is, Sri Mata Vaishno Devi Shrine of Jammu and Kashmir. Now the next question. The country Dash, which will host the FIFA World Cup 2022, has unveiled the official emblem. And the answer here is, it's Qatar. And who is the president of FIFA? It's Gianni Infantino. He's the president of FIFA. And where is the headquarter? It's Zurich of Switzerland. Which country has topped the WEF's World Travel and Tourism Competitive Index 2019? And the answer here is, it has been topped by Spain, and it has followed by France and Germany. Now the next question, what is the rank of India in World Travel and Tourism Competitiveness Index 2019 of WEF? And the answer here is, India stands at 34th position. Next question, what is the ranks of New Delhi and Mumbai in EIU's Most Livable City in the World 2019 ranking? And the answer here is, Delhi and Mumbai has stood at 118th and 119th place. Which city has topped the EIU's Most Livable City in the World 2019 ranking? And the answer here is, it has been topped by Vienna. ESICS has tied up with Swiss Bank to provide electronic payment services for the beneficiaries of ESICS. And answer here is, it has been tied up with State Bank. And this ESIS has tied up with State Bank for direct transfer of benefits electronically into bank accounts of all stakeholders. And SBI will provide a e-payment service directly to the bank accounts of all ESIS beneficiaries and payees without any manual intervention. And who is the Director General of ESIS? It's Raj Kumar. He's the Director General of ESIS. And who is the chairperson of SBI? It's Rajnish Kumar. And who has been named as the head of the panel constituted by IRDAI to review its guidelines on trade credit insurance? And the answer here is, it's Atul Sahai. Now the next question, which airport has unveiled India's tallest ATC tower for better air transport management service? And the answer here is, it's Indira Gandhi International Airport of Delhi. So this airport has gets India's tallest air traffic control tower to enhance the safety and to boost the efficiency of air transport management services. Now the next question, who has been elected as the chairman of Association of World Election Bodies for the 2019 and 21 terms? And the answer here is, it's Sunil Arora, and he will be serving for 2 years till 2021. The joint military exercise, that is Yudh Abhyas 2019, will be held between Indian Army and DAS. And it is going to be held between Indian Army and United States. Now the next question, Samudrayan project is a pilot project of which ministry? And this is the pilot project of Ministry of Earth Science. In which state did the Vice President of India recently inaugurated the India's longest electrified rail tunnel? And the answer here is, it's Andhra Pradesh. What is India's GDP growth rate in financial year 2020 as per the Fitch Solutions? And the answer is, it's 6.4%. Tejinder Pal won a silver medal in which event at the Czech Republic of Athletic Meet? And the answer here is, and he has won in shot put throw. Now the next question, which state will host the 36th National Games from October 20 to November 4th of 2020? And the answer here is, it's Goa. Next question, who has been named for the 2019 Global Goalkeeper Award by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation? And the answer here is, it's Narendra Modi. Now the next question, what is rank of India in the Ipsos Global Happiness Survey 2019? And the answer here is it's 9th position. Now the next question, which country tied at the top spot in Ipsos Global Happiness Survey 2019? And it has been topped by Australia and Canada. Now the next question, which state has won IT Excellence Award 2019 in Disaster Management? And the answer here is Odisha. So this awarded for its innovative conception by using information technology in the field of disaster management. So the app named as Satark. It stands for System for Assessing, Tracking and Alerting Disaster Risk Information based on Dynamic Risk Knowledge. And this application has been chosen for this award. And this app has been developed to provide real-time watch, alert and warning information for different natural disaster and hazards. Now the next question, according to the latest estimation of rating agency CRISIL, what is the GDP growth of India for financial year 2019 to 2020? And the answer here is it's 6.3. Who is the Managing Director and CEO of CRISIL? It's Ashu Suyash. And this rating agency has revised India's fiscal year 2020 GDP growth forecast to 6.3%. And earlier it has predicted a GDP growth of 6.9%. Now the next question, who has appointed as the next High Commissioner of India to Lesotho? And the answer here is, it's Jaideep Sarkar. So what's the capital of Lesotho? It's Maseru. And currency is South African Rand. Now the next question, the first ever national conference on cybercrime investigation and forensic was organized in which city by the CBI? And the answer here is, it's New Delhi. It is a 2-day conference aimed at creating the platform and bringing together investigators, lawyers, forensic experts and academics to discuss the challenges those are related to cybercrimes and to find the ways to get the solutions, right? And who is the director of Central Bureau of Investigation? It's Rishi Kumar Shukla. He's the director of CBI. Now the next question, which state has topped the 2019 logistic ease across the different states index? And the answer here is, it has been topped by Gujarat. And it has been followed by Punjab and Andhra Pradesh. And it is released by the Union Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Piyush Goyal. Now the next question, Mukhyamantri Dal Poshit Yojana has launched by which state to provide pulses at subsidized rate to ration card holders? And the answer here is, it has been introduced by Uttarakhand. So where is the capital of Uttarakhand? It's in Dehradun. Governor is Baby Rani Maurya and Chief Minister is Trivendra Singh Rawat. So here the Uttarakhand Chief Minister has launched this scheme called Mukhyamantri Dal Poshit Yojana to provide the state ration card holders 2 kgs of 2 different varieties of pulses available at price much lower than market price. Now the next question, what is the name of the second indigenous developed airborne early warning control aircraft by Defense Research and Development Organization and handed over to the Indian Air Force? And the answer here is, it's Netra. And who is the Chief of Air Staff? It's Marshal B.S. Dhanova. And where is the headquarter of DRDO, that is Defense Research and Development Organization? It is located in New Delhi and it was established in the year 1958. And who is the chairperson of DRDO? It's G. Satish Reddy. Which organization has signed a memorandum of understanding with Ministry of Railways for facilitating green initiatives in Indian Railways? And the answer here is, it's Confederation of Indian Industry. That stands for CII. So where is the headquarter located? It is in New Delhi. And it was established in the year 1895. And who is the president of CII, that is Confederation of Indian Industry? It's Srikanth Kirloskar. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the first chancellor of the Haryana Sports University? And the answer here is, it's Kapil Dev. So what's the capital of Haryana? It's Chandigarh. Who is the chief minister? Manohar Lal Khattar. And governor is Satyadev Arya. Now the next question, who is the former Indian Army Lieutenant General who was appointed to lead United Missions in the port city of Hodeidah of Yemen? And the answer here is, it's Abhijit Guha. And he has replaced Michael Lulisgard. So what's the capital of Yemen? It's Sana. And currency is Yemeni Riyal. Now the next question, who won the bronze medal in the World Under 16 Snooker Championship 2019 held in Russia? And the answer here is, it's Ranbir Dugal. So what's the capital of Russia? It's Moscow, and currency is Russian ruble. Now the next question, Maitri 2019, a joint military exercise will be conducted in Meghalaya by Indian Army with which country? And the answer here is, it's Thailand. So what's the capital of Thailand? Is Bangkok, and currency is Thai Baht. And it is going to be held from 16th September to 29th September in Umroi of Meghalaya. The nationwide Swachhata Hi Seva, that is SHS 2019 campaign, has been inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi from which of these cities? And the answer here is, it has been inaugurated in Mathura. And what is the theme of this campaign? This is plastic waste awareness and management. What will be the rate of monthly pension given to the self-employed under the Swarajgar pension scheme? And the answer here is, it's 3000 rupees. The Mukhyamantri Vyapari Samuhik Niji Durghatna Bima Yojana and Mukhyamantri Vyapari Khyatipurti Bima Yojana are the two insurance schemes for traders launched by which state? And the answer here is, this has been launched by Haryana. And who is the chief minister of Haryana? It's Manohar Lal Khattar. Governor is Satyadev Arya, right? And under this two insurance scheme, this Mukhyamantri Vyapari Samuhik Niji Durghatna Bima Yojana, under this they will be covered around 5 lakh rupees. And under Mukhyamantri Vyapari Khyatipurti Bima Yojana, it will be around 5 to 25 lakh rupees. Now the next question, the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has launched a mobile app named CHC Farm Machinery for the farmers. What does this CHC stands for? And this stands for Customer Hiring Service Centers. And this has been launched by the Ministry of Agriculture, Narendra Singh Tomar, who is the Indian ambassador to UAE, has conferred with the first class order of Jayed 2 award. And the answer here is, and this has been conferred to Navdeep Singh Suri. What's the capital of UAE? It's Abu Dhabi and currency is dirham. Now the next question, who has been conferred with the 2019-20 Lata Mangeshkar Award? And the answer here is, it has been given to Usha Khanna. Now the next question, who among these has been named to be inducted into the 2019 Asia Pacific Golf Hall of Fame? And the answer here is, it's Pawan Munjal. Now the next question, which of these sports administrative body has recently been de-recognized by the sports ministry? And the answer here is, it's Paralympic Committee of India. Next question, which of these university has topped the Times Higher Education World University Rankings 2020? And the answer here is, it has been topped by University of Oxford. Next question, which university in India has achieved the top position among Indian institutions in the Times Higher Education World University Ranking 2020? And it has been taught by Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Now the next question, which country recently inaugurated the Southeast Asia's largest solar power farm? And the answer here is, it's Vietnam. So what's the capital of Vietnam? It's Hanoi. It's the capital of Vietnam and currency is Vietnamese dong. Who has appointed as the new managing director of Microsoft India Research and Development Private Limited? And the answer here is, it's Rajiv Kumar and he will replace Anil Vansali. Now the next question, which entity planned to launch the mobile app to enable the visually impaired people identify the currency notes? And the answer here is, it's RBI. Now the next question, the Motihari Amalkhans petroleum product pipeline is the first ever cross-border petroleum products pipeline in South Asia between India and DAS. And this pipeline is between India and Nepal. So what's the capital of Nepal? It's Kathmandu. It was proposed in 1996 and the length of this pipeline is 69 km and this will help in tackling the oil storage problem in Nepal. Now the next question. India Post Payment Bank has rolled out AEPS service. What does P stands in AEPS? And the answer here is, P stands for payment. So what does this abbreviation AEPS stands for? It stands for Aadhaar Enabled Payment System. And with this, Indian Post Payment Bank will become the single largest platform in the country for providing their customer interoperable banking services. So where is the headquarter of this Indian Post Payment Bank located? It is in New Delhi. And it was established in the year 2018. And who is the MD and CEO? It's Suresh P. Shetty. He is the MD and CEO of IPPB. Now the next question, who is the chairman of Alibaba Group who has recently stepped down from the post? And the answer here is, it's Jack Ma. He was the chairman of Alibaba Group. Now the present chairman is Daniel Zhang. He is the present chairman of Alibaba Group. Now the next question, who among these has been selected for the 2019 Sarla Puraskar? And the answer here is, it's Pradeep Das. And he is an Odia writer who has been recently inducted as the honorary fellow of the Royal Society for his service to the cause of science. And the answer here is, it's Yusuf Hamid. A fun zone, the first of its kind in India, has been set up by the railways at the Dyess railway station in Andhra Pradesh. And the answer here is, the fun zone has been set up in Visakhapatnam and it is in Andhra Pradesh. And who is the railway minister? It's Piyush Goyal, which will set up the country's first international women's trade center in consonance with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. And the answer here is, it's Kerala. So what's the capital of Kerala? It's Thiruvananthapuram. Now the next question. Country's first ever helicopter summit was held at Dyess on September 7th by the Ministry of Civil Aviation. And the answer here is, it was held in Dehradun. It's the capital of Uttarakhand. So what is the theme of this summit? This is expanding connectivity through helicopters. This was the theme of this summit. Who among the following has been unanimously elected as the chairman of the country's premier news agency, Press Trust of India? And the answer here is, it's Vijay Kumar Chopra. And here Vijay Kumar Chopra has been unanimously elected as the chairman of Press Trust of India, succeeding N. Ravi. And Press Trust of India headquarters is in New Delhi, and it was established in the year 1947. Now the next question, who among the following defeated Daniil Medvedev to grab the US Open 2019 men's single title? And the answer here is, it's Rafael Nadal. Minister of Food Processing Industries inaugurated first food park in Dyess. And the answer here is, it has been inaugurated in Telangana. So it has been set up at a cost of 109 crore. And this is a smart agro food park. It's estimated to provide direct and indirect employment opportunity of around 50,000 youth and benefits around 1 lakh farmers in these regions. And under this food park scheme, the center provides an assistance of up to 50 crore. And what is the objective of this food park? This park gives us boost of food processing sector by adding value and reducing the food wastage at each stage of the supply chain with a particular focus on perishables. Now the next question, India and Dyess concluded a military logistic agreement to extend the logistical support to each other's navies. And the answer here is, it's South Korea. Who among the following defeated Serena Williams to grab the US Open 2019 women's single title? And the answer here is, it's Bianca Andreescu. Now the next question, Dyess hosted the 22nd session of United Nations Committee on Convention on Rights of Persons with Disability. And the answer here is, it is hosted in Geneva. Now the next question, who among the following has been appointed as the Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court? And the answer is, it's Vikram Nath. The Poshan Abhiyan 2019 has been started with which mass media campaign? And the answer here is, it has been started with the campaign Eat Right India. Now the next question, which country has been declared free from avian influenza, that is H5N1? And the answer here is, it's India. Fortuner Turner's The Quartet That Spun India to Glory book on India's four spin legends was launched recently. And who among the following is not among them? And the answer here is, it's Anil Kumble. So apart from Anil Kumble, the four spinners, that is Vishan Singh Bedi, Erappalli Prasanna, S. Venkat Raghavan and Bhagwat Chandrasekhar, these four spinners on this book has written, that is Fortune Turners. Now the next question, which sprinter has recently completed the fastest half marathon, the Great North Run, ever run by a woman in a time of 1 hour 44 minutes and 28 seconds? And the answer here is, it's Brigid Kosgei. And she is from Kenya. What's the capital of Kenya? It's Nairobi. And currency is Kenyan shilling. Who among the following who passed away recently was a former union minister and also served as the chairman of the Bar Council of India? And the answer here is Ram Jethmalani. And he was a six-time Rajya Sabha member and served as the union minister in the United Front and NDA government. And apart from him, if you look at the other option, the second option is given Viru Krishnan. He also passed away recently and he was an actor and Kathak dancer. And the third option is Abdul Qadir. He is a Pakistan master leg spinner who passed away recently. And the fourth option is Sukhdev Singh Libra, a Congress leader and the member of 14th and 15th Lok Sabha, who passed away recently. And the fifth one is Rajsekhar, and he is a Tamil film director, actor and cinematographer who passed away recently. Now the next question, on which day the International Association for Suicide Prevention observes the World Suicide Prevention Day every year? And the answer here is, it's on 10th September. Now the next question, and Hindi Divas is observed annually on DAS and it is observed on 14th September. On which day the United Nations observes International Literacy Day every year? And the answer here is, it is observed on 8th of September. What was the agri digital platform launched by Bank of Baroda? And the answer here is, it's Baroda Kishan. So this is a web-based portal launched by Bank of Baroda to meet all the expectation of farmers' requirement, and it provides the details including the weather forecast, crop conditions, and the moisture level of soils, and also it informs the crop worms, market price of the crops, and special crop-related consultation. So who is the MD and CEO of Bank of Baroda? It's P.S. Jai Kumar. Is the MD and CEO of Bank of Baroda, and the headquarter is located in Vadodara. And what's the tagline of this bank? It's India's International Bank. Who has been elected as the new chairman of the Audit Bureau of Circulation for 2019 and 20? And the answer here is, it's Madhukar Kamat. And he was the chairman emeritus of DDB Mudra Group, and he has been elected as the chairman of Audit Bureau of Circulation for the year 2019 to 2020. Now the next question, Alison Rose appointed as chief executive officer to which bank as his first woman CEO? And the answer here is, she has been appointed as the chief executive officer of Royal Bank of Scotland. So she is the first woman to lead the Britain's biggest bank. Now the next question, who won the silver medal in the World Boxing Championship 2019 to become the first Indian boxer to win a silver medal for India in the tournament of history? And the answer here is, it's Amit Panghal. Now the next question, who won the silver medal in 86 category at the World Championship in Nur Sultan of Kazakhstan? And the answer here is, it's Deepak Punia. Now the next question, who won the women's single title in China Open 2019? And the answer here is, it's Carolina Marin. Next question, who won the 2019 China Open men's badminton title? And the answer is, it's Kento Momota. Next question, who is the director of the Bollywood film Gully Boy, which has been nominated for Oscar 2019 in Best Foreign Language Film category? And the answer here is, it's Joya Akhtar. Next question, who died recently was associated with the cricket? And answer here is, it's Madhav Apte. And if you look at the option here, the first option is given Sivaraman, and he is a renowned writer who passed away recently, and he belongs to Kerala. And the third option is given Sanjeev Kumar Datta. He was a film editor who passed away recently. And the fourth option is given Sathar. He is a Malayalam actor who passed away recently. And the fifth one is given Jill Al Abidinan Ben Ali. He is the Tunisia's former president who passed away. The Indian Army recently conducted a military drill named Exercise Chang Thang Prahar in which of these regions? And the answer here is, it has been conducted in Ladakh. And it was a rare exercise in eastern Ladakh border in China. And such massive exercise is held for the first time in this region. And it was conducted at an altitude of 12,000 feet. Now the next question, who is the author of the book Being Gandhi? And the answer here is, it's Paro Anand. And this book titled Being Gandhi has been authored by this award-winning author Paro Anand, and it is marked on behalf of the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. And this book describes the life events of Gandhiji. What is the new corporate tax rate for the domestic companies as announced by the finance minister recently? And the answer here is, it's 22%. So this has been come down from the 30%. And also CA announced the effective corporate tax rate for the companies would be 25.17%. And this is including all the surcharges. And for the new manufacturing companies, the existing tax has been reduced to 15%. And the tax with all surcharges will be 17% for the new manufacturing companies. And who is the finance minister? Is Nirmala Sitaram. And she belongs to which constituency? She belongs to Andhra Pradesh. Now the next question here, who is the head of the working group constituted by SEBI for Social Stock Exchange, that is SSE? And the answer here is Ishat Hussain. So he is one of the directors of SBI Foundation. So what does this Social Stock Exchange? This is a platform that allows investors to buy shares in a social enterprises that has been allowed by the exchange. And the aim of this initiative is to help the social and volunteer organization which works for the social causes. Now the next question. Data Security Council of India has partnered with IT Ministry and which organization to launch the awareness campaign named Digital Payment Abhiyan? And the answer here is, it's Google India. So the NASCOM's Data Security Council of India has collaborated with the Union Ministry of Electronics and IT and Google India to launch this nationwide campaign named Digital Payment Abhiyan. And who is the Ministry of Electronics and IT? It's Ravi Shankar Prasad. And this aims at increasing the awareness about the cashless payment and educating the people about the benefit of making digital payments. So this Data Security Council of India was established in the year 2008. And who was the chairman? It's G.K. Pillai. So what does this NASCOM stand for? That is National Association of Software and Services Companies, and headquarters is located in New Delhi. And NASCOM was established in the year 1988. And who is the chairperson? It's Rishad Premji. He's the chairperson of NASCOM. Which state government has decided to declare 2020 as Artificial Intelligence Year by organizing various activities related to the emerging technology? And the answer here is, it's Telangana. So who is the Chief Minister of Telangana? It's K. Chandrasekhar Rao. And Governor is Tamilsai Soundararajan. Now the next question here. The first of its kind international conference on sustainability education 2019 was held at India Habitat Center in which city on 9th to 10th September 2019? And the answer here is, it was held in New Delhi. So this conference looked into the ways to address the challenges related to sustainability of education, climate change education, and environmental education in the current course of curriculum. Now the next question, India's first world environment school will be set up in which state? And the answer here is, it is going to be set up in Karnataka. And this is Asia's first environment school named World Environment School in Coorg, and it will be operational from 2021. And who is the Chief Minister of Karnataka? B.S. Yediyurappa, and Governor is Bajubhai Bhalla. Now the next question, which ministry announced a new public-private partnership scheme, that is National Education Alliance for Technology? And the answer here is, it's Ministry of Human Resource and Development. It aimed to improve the learning outcomes in higher education institution. Under this NEET, that is National Education Alliance for Technology, the Human Resource and Development Ministry will act as a facilitator, and he will be responsible for enabling all the free and fair availability of technology to the students. Now the next question, the first ever Central Police University of India is proposed to be set up in which city? And the answer here is, it is going to be set up in Greater Noida of UP. And this multi-purpose disciplinary university will provide dynamic state-of-art learning and working environment for advancement of education and research in science. Now the next question, the mobile app Tatpar has been launched by which state police to provide over 50 citizen-centric services in single app? And the answer here is, it is launched in Delhi. Now the next question, who has been named as the new chief of air staff of the Indian Air Force? And the answer here is, RKS Bhadauria. And he is going to replace B.S. Dhanoa. Now the next question, who has been named as UEFA Women's Player of the Year 2018-19? And the answer here is Lucy Bronze. Next question, who has been named as UEFA Men's Player of the Year for 2018-19? And the answer here is Virgil van Dijk. Now the next question, who has been felicitated in the US with the prestigious Educational Excellence Award 2019 by the Foundation for Excellence? And the answer here is, it's Anand Kumar. So he is a founder of Super 30 and a noted mathematician. You might have seen the movie Super 30. And this award has been felicitated by the US government with the prestigious Educational Excellence Award. So Anand has been running a highly innovative Super 30 program from the last 18 years. And he mentors 30 students free of cost through a year for the India's premium exam, that is IIT JEE. Now the next question, which documentary film based on struggle of a farmer in a remote village of Uttarakhand has been nominated for the Oscar? And the answer here is, it's Moti Bagh. So who is the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand? It's Trivendra Singh Rawat, and Governor is Baby Rani Maurya. Now the next question, which institution of India has achieved the top position in Forbes, that's the Best Business School 2019 ranking? And the answer here is, it's Indian School of Business, Hyderabad. Which bank has launched Bharosa Savings Account? And the answer here is, it's Airtel Payments Bank. So who is the CEO of Airtel Payment Bank? It's Anubrat Biswas. And the headquarter is located in New Delhi. It is established in the year 2019. So this Airtel Payment Bank has announced that this Bharosa scheme account to deepen the financial inclusion in the country. So this account offers free personal accident insurance cover worth 5 lakhs on maintaining a balance of just ₹500 along with one debit transaction per month. Now the next question, according to the survey of currency market by the Bank of International Settlement, which city has overtaken India's financial capital Mumbai as the top center for the trading of Indian rupee? And the answer here is, it's London. So London has surpassed Mumbai. Now the next question, who won the bronze medal in 53 kg at World Wrestling Championship in Nur Sultan, Kazakhstan, and secured a place in Tokyo Olympics qualification. And the answer here is it's Vinesh Phogat. So who is the Prime Minister of Kazakhstan? It's Askar Mamin. And what is the capital of Kazakhstan? It's Nur Sultan. And currency is Kazakhstani tenge. Now the next question. Bing Duen Duen is the name of the official mascot for the Winter Olympics 2022. Where is the venue of Winter Olympics 2022? And the answer here is it's Beijing. And this new Olympic mascot will serve as an ambassador for winter sports, bringing joy to those who participate in and watch the Olympic Winter Games. And this mascot will personify the strength and willpower of the athletes and will help to promote the Olympic spirits. So in this Bing Duen Duen, what does this Bing stands for? This means ice and also symbolizes the purity and strength, whereas Duen Duen means children. Now the next question. Who won the Best Actress Award in the 20th edition of International Indian Film Academy Awards? And the answer here is it's Alia Bhatt. And she has been awarded as the best actress for the movie Raji, and whereas the movie Raji itself has been awarded as the best film. And apart from her, Ranbir Singh has been awarded as the best actor for the movie of Padmavat, and the best director award has been given to Sriram Raghavan for the movie Andhadhun. Now the next question. So who was awarded by the Union Minister for the Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Dr. Mahendranath Pandey, with the Eminent Engineers Award on 52nd Engineers Day? And the answer here is it's Vinod Kumar Yadav. And he is the chairman of Railway Board with the Eminent Engineers Award. And the theme of this 52nd Engineers Day was Engineering for Change. So who is the Ministry of Railway? It's Piyush Goyal. Now the next question. So who won the Amnesty International's Ambassador of Conscience Award for their work highlighting the need of urgent action to avert the climate disaster? And the answer here is it has been awarded to Greta Thunberg. She's a Swedish environmental activist. So what's the capital of Sweden? It's Stockholm, and currency is Swedish krona. Now the next question. According to the National Migrant Stock 2019 released by the United Department of Economic and Social Affairs, which country has topped it? And the answer here is it has been topped by India. Now Indian diaspora has comprises around 6.4% of the total global migrant population. Now the UAE was the top destination of Indian migrants, followed by US and Saudi Arabia. And the count of Indian diaspora has increased around 10%, and Bangladesh was a top source of migrants to India, followed by Pakistan and Nepal. Now the next question. Which country has unveiled the South Asia's tallest TV tower, dubbed as Lotus Tower? And the answer here is it's in Sri Lanka. So it is around 350 meter tall, which is named as Lotus Tower. Now the next question. Who has been appointed as the first Lokayukt of Andhra Pradesh? And the answer here is it's P. Laxman Reddy. Now the next question. Who has been appointed as National Security Advisor of United States of America? And the answer here is it's Robert O'Brien. So he is going to replace John Bolton. Who became India's first female military diplomat to join India's mission abroad after joining the Indian embassy in Russia? And the answer here is it's Anjali Singh. So who is the president of Russia? It's Vladimir Putin. What's the capital? Moscow. And currency is Russian ruble. Now the next question here. Arcadia Education Project, which involves the construction of floating schools for marginalized children in South Kanarchur of Das, has been awarded as the prestigious Aga Khan Architecture Award 2019. And the answer here is it's Bangladesh. So what's the capital of Bangladesh? It's Dhaka. currency is Taka. Who is the Prime Minister? Sheikh Hasina. ECGC has launched a new scheme that is NIRVIK for easy loan availability for exporters. Under this scheme, ECGC will provide credit guarantee of 1% in case of loss of goods and services exported. And the answer here is it's 90%. Now the next question. What was the automated system launched by the government to provide advance information about steel imports to government and stakeholders? And the answer here is it's steel import management solution. So who is the IPS officer has been selected for the 2019 ACS Society Game Changers Award for investigating the 2012 Nirbhaya gang rape? And the answer here is it's Chaya Sharma. So she has been awarded with the 2019 ACS Society Game Changer Award. Now the next question, who among the following has been conferred with the Dr. Kalam? So who among the following has been conferred with the Dr. Kalam Smriti International Excellence Award 2019 in Dhaka? And the answer here is it's Sheikh Hasina. She is the Prime Minister of Bangladesh and she received this prestigious award for the vision of a peaceful and prosperous South Asian country which is free of tension, conflicts and terrorism. Which country has won the 2019 FIBA Basket World Cup? And the answer here is it's Spain. So Spain has won to the 2019 FIBA Basket World Cup, but in spite of that, US is still ranked number one in the world in basketball, whereas Spain is on second position and Australia is on third position. The public information portal Jan Sujna Portal 2019 has been launched by which state? And it has been launched by Rajasthan. Now the next question. So what's the capital of Rajasthan? It's Jaipur and Chief Minister is Ashok Kumar Gehlot and Governor is Kalraj Mishra. The exercise named Him Vijay 2019 is scheduled to be held in which state by the Indian Army? And the answer here is it is going to be held in Arunachal Pradesh and Assam. Who among these has won 2019 Vietnam Open BWF Tour Super 100? And the answer here is it's Saurabh Verma. And the next question. Which state tourism has won three prestigious Pacific Asia Travel Association Gold Awards in Nur Sultan of Kazakhstan? And the answer here is it has been awarded to Kerala. So what's the capital of Kerala? Is Thiruvananthapuram. Who is the governor? Is Arif Mohammed Khan. And Chief Minister is P. Vijayan. Now the next question. The 71st Annual Primetime Emmy Awards honor handed out to Dash for Outstanding Drama Series. And the answer here is it's Fleabag. So it has been awarded as an Outstanding Comedy Series, whereas Game of Thrones has been awarded as Outstanding Drama Series. Now the next question. Which country has topped the Global Economic Freedom Index 2019 by Fraser Institute? And the answer here is it has been topped by Hong Kong. So the two Asian economies, that is Hong Kong and Singapore, are in the top position. And the next highest scoring nations are New Zealand, Switzerland and US. And India stood at 79th position. Now the next question. The theme of the International Day of Peace or World Peace Day for the year 2019 is a climate action for peace, and it is observed every year on which day? And it is observed on 21st of September. Now the next question. On which day United Nations observes the International Day for the Preservation of the Ozone Layer every year? And the answer here is it's on September 16. Now the next question. What was the theme of the International Day for the Preservation of the Ozone Layer for 2019? And the answer here is the theme was 32 years and healing. Now the next question. Whose birth anniversary is celebrated as Engineers Day on the 15th of September every year? And the answer here is it is celebrated on behalf of M. Visveswaraya. And he considered one of the finest engineers of the country, and he is also best known for his planned economy for India and reconstructing India, which is the first of its kind to describe country's planning efforts. Now the next question. On which date International Day of Democracy 2019 held? And the answer here is, it is on 15th of September. Now the next question, World Bamboo Day is observed every year on DAS. It is observed every year on September 18th. So it's all about the creating the awareness about the conserving and promoting the bamboo industry. Now the next question, International Day of Peace is observed every year on DASH and it is observed every year on 21st September. And what is the theme for International Day of Peace 2019? It is Climate Action for Peace. So the first question here, who has been appointed as brand ambassador by Madhya Pradesh government to promote the state's tradition and tourist places? And the answer here is, it's TV actor Govinda. So what's the capital of Madhya Pradesh? It's Bhopal. Who is the chief minister? Kamal Nath. And governor is Lalji Tandon. Now the next question, the ICC has inked an agreement with Facebook under which the social media platform will get exclusive digital content rights for cricket matches in India subcontinent. So who is the chief executive officer of ICC? And the answer is, it's Manu Sahani. Now the next question, who received the MP Birla Memorial Award 2019 for his contribution to the world of cosmology? And the answer here is, it's Thanu Padmanabhan. And this award is established in the year 1993 and this is given to give the recognition in excellence in research in space science, astrophysics, astronomy and related areas. Now the next question, payment technology company Visa signed up with DASH as its brand ambassador for another 2 years. And the answer here is, it's PV Sindhu. And apart from PV Sindhu, if you look at the option, the first one is Madhuri Dixit and she has been chosen as goodwill ambassador by the chief electoral officer in Maharashtra to create awareness among the people regarding voting. Now the next question, who became the first woman officer from Arunachal Pradesh to be elevated to the rank of Lieutenant Colonel in Indian Army? And the answer here is, it's Poonam Dhoming. So who is the Chief of Army Staff? It's General Bipin Rawat. Now the next question, who won the Skolkova Fights Grand Prix title 2019 held in Russia? And the answer here is, it's Humpy Konnerud. So the chess grandmaster Humpy Konnerud belongs to Andhra Pradesh and he has defeated Wen Junzhu of China. He has defeated of China. Who was appointed as the next ambassador of India to Republic of Guinea-Bissau? And the answer here is, it's Godavarit Venkat Srinivasa. And he will succeed Partha Satpathy. And who is the president of Guinea-Bissau? Is Jose Mario Vaz. The president, and Aristides Ghom is the prime minister. And what is the currency? It's West African franc. Now we'll move to the next question. The Indian Space Research Organization initiated DASH, an early warning system in space to detect the debris and other hazards to Indian satellites. And the answer here is, it's Project Netra. So where is the headquarters of ISRO? It is in Bangalore. And who is the head of ISRO? K. Sivan. World Hindu Economic Forum 2019 held in which city? And it was held in Mumbai. So Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. So who is the chief minister of Maharashtra? Is Devendra Fadnavis. Governor is Bhagat Singh Koshyari. And what is the theme of this World Hindu Economic Forum? It's prosperous society and stronger society. This is the theme of this World Hindu Economic Forum. And what is the intention behind conducting this? To bring all together all the financially successful members in Hindu society, such as like traders, bankers, technocrats, investors, or industrialists, to share their business knowledge with the others. Now the next question, who has won the WTA Wuhan Open held in Wuhan of China? And the answer here is, it's Arina Sabalenka. Now the next question, who has won the men's single title at the ATP Challengers tournament held in Buenos Aires of Argentina? And the answer here is, it's Sumit Nagal. So India's Sumit Nagal has defeated Argentina's Facundo Bogdis. And he belongs to Argentina. Now the next question, who unveiled the centralized public grievances redress and monitoring system reforms in Department of Post in New Delhi? And the answer here is, it's Jitendra Singh. Now the next question, the Reserve Bank of India has put which bank under prompt corrective action framework due to high bad loans and insufficient capitals? And the answer here is, it's Lakshmi Vilas Bank. So where is the head office of Lakshmi Vilas Bank? It's in Chennai. And who is the MD and CEO? It's Partha Sarathy Mukherjee. Now the next question, who won the Russian Grand Prix 2019? And the answer here is, it's Lewis Hamilton. Now the next question, who won the men's singles title at Korea Open Badminton Tournament? And the answer here is, it's Kento Momota. Now the next question, who honored with the 28th Saraswati Samman for the creation of his famous poetry collection, that is Pakkaki Utthi Gilithe in Telugu in 2018? And the answer here is, it's Dr. K. Shiva Reddy. Now the next question, who among these has won 2019 Punya Bhushan Award? And the answer here is, it has been won by Dr. G. V. Digulkar. And this archaeologist Dr. G.B. Digulkar was conferred with the prestigious Punya Bhushan Award for his long outstanding contribution to the field of Indian archaeology. And what does this Punya Bhushan mean? In Marathi, it is mean Jewel of Pune. And this award has been instituted by Pune based on Punya Bhushan Foundation. Now the next question, which airport was named as the best airport in 5 to 15 million passenger category in terms of services it offered to the passenger as per the Airport Council International? And the answer here is, it's Cochin International Airport Limited. So as per the annual report service quality survey conducted by the ACI, that is Airport Council International, Cochin International Airport Limited ranked amongst the best airport. Now the next question, Dash Metro will be named after Indian King Raja Bhose and it will be called as Bhose Metro. And the answer here is, it's Bhopal. So Bhopal is the capital of Madhya Pradesh. Which state has unveiled a mascot named Tikki Mousy to spread the public awareness about child and women's nutrition and their development? And the answer here is, it has been unveiled by Odisha. So this Tikki Mousy will also give the information about the various services like Sakhi centers and schemes like Mamata, Biju Shishu Surakhya Yojana. And these programs with the active help of panchayat representatives and women self-help groups. Who topped in the United World Wrestling ranking in the 86th category? And the answer here is, it has been topped by Deepak Punia. Now the next question, which Indian company has won United Nations Global Climate Action Award? And the answer here is, it's Infosys. Now the next question, which state won the best state award in National Tourism Award 2017-18? And it has been won by Andhra Pradesh. Now the next question, joint military exercise that is Kazin 2019 has held between India and Daesh at Pithoragarh of Uttarakhand from 2nd to 15 October 2019. And the answer here is, it's Kazakhstan. So this exercise is the fourth edition. And who is the Prime Minister of Kazakhstan? That is Aksar Mamin. Aksar Mamin is the Prime Minister. And what is the capital? It's Nur Sultan. And currency is tenge. Now the next question. Who is the head of Economic Advisor Council to the Prime Minister? And the answer here is, Bibek Debroy. Now the next question, who is the author of the book Reset, Regaining India's Economy Legacy? And the answer here is, Subramanyam Swamy. Which company topped the list of 75 most valued brands in India according to the report by WPP and Kantar Millward Brown? And the answer here is, HDFC Bank. Who among the following take over as the chairman of Chief of Staff Commission? And the answer here is, General Bipin Rawat. Now the next question, the President of Athletics Federation of India Dash, who was re-elected as the member of the Council of the International Association of Athletic Federation for a second term for another 4 years? And the answer here is, Adile Sumariwala. Now the next question, KPS Menon passed away recently was a DAS and he was the former foreign secretary. And he was Indian Foreign Service Officer that is from 1951 batch, and he served as an ambassador to various countries including Bangladesh, Egypt, Japan and China. Now the next question, who won the Mrs. India Pride of the Nation 2019 title? And the answer here is, Pooja Desai. Now the next question, who among the following was the Emmy Award winner passed away recently? And the answer is, J. Michael. He was the Emmy Award winner who passed away recently. And apart from that, if you look at other options, the first option is given Jacques Chirac, and he was the former French president who passed away. And the third option is given Venu Madhav. He was a Telugu actor who passed away. And the fourth option is given Robert S. Boyd, who is an American journalist and Pulitzer Prize winner. He also passed away. Now the next question, where is the headquarter of international campaign to abolish nuclear weapons? And the answer here is, it is located in Geneva. Now the next question, what was India's rank in the IMD World Digital Competitiveness Ranking 2019? And the answer is, 44. So in this IMD World Digital Competitive Ranking Index 2019, US has topped the rank, followed by Singapore, and how did they examine this? Based upon the three factors, those are the knowledge, the capacity to understand and learn the new technology, and the second one is technology, the competence to develop new digital innovation, and the third one is future readiness, that is how much preparedness for the upcoming developments. Now the next question, who appointed as the first woman president of Tamil Nadu Cricket Association? And the answer here is, Rupa Gurunath. The next question here, who has been honored with the National Tourism Award for the category of Best Tourist Guide for year 2017-18 during the celebration of the World Tourism Day? And the answer here is, Tapan Kumar Mishra. And he hails from Orissa. He is a freelancer tourist guide approved by the Union Ministry of Tourism. Who occupied the second place in the list of richest Indians as per the IIFL Wealth Hurun Indian Rich List 2019? And the answer here is, it's SP Hinduja Group and Family. And this has been taught by Mukesh Ambani, who is the chairman of Reliance Industry. The Asian Development Bank lowered India's growth rate forecast from 7.2% to dash for current fiscal. And the answer here is, it's 6.5%. Now the next question. Pankaj Advani and Aditya Mehta pair own the IBSF World Snooker Team event held in which country? And it was held in Myanmar. So India defeated Thailand in this team event. Now the next question. Who has appointed as the new head of the International Monetary Fund? And the answer here is Kristalina Georgieva. Now the next question. Who was re-elected as the president of the International Association of Athletics Federation, that is IAAF? And the answer here is, it's Sebastian Coe. Now the next question. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the Association of Mutual Funds in India? And the answer here is, it's Nilesh Shah. The Association of Mutual Funds in India is an industry standards organization in India. And it was formed in the year 1995. And headquarters is located in Mumbai. And here Nilesh Shah, he will replace Managing Director and CEO of ICC Prudential Asset Management, that is Nimesh Shah. So he is going to replace Nimesh Shah. Now the next question. Who was awarded as the Changemaker Award by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation? And the answer here is, it's Payal Jangid. And she is just 17 years old, belongs to Rajasthan, and she became the first Indian to receive this Changemaker Award 2019 at the Goalkeepers Award Goals Award. And she was awarded for her work towards the abolition of child marriage in her village and other neighboring areas. Now the next question. Who among the following named the winners of the Right Livelihood Award, also known as Alternative Novel? And the answer here is, it's Greta Thunberg. Now the next question. Who will be awarded for the Sastra Ramanujan Prize for the year 2019? And the answer here is, it's Adam Harper. And he is a mathematician, and this award is conferred annually on mathematicians from across the world who are less than 32 years of age. And Adam Harper is an assistant professor with the University of Warwick of England. Which Indian company ranked at the third in Forbes annual list of the world's best regarded companies 2019? And the answer here is, it's Infosys. Which state became the first state in the country to issue highest number of golden cards under Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana? And the answer here is, it's Jammu and Kashmir. So who is the governor of Jammu Kashmir? It's Satyapal Malik. Now the next question. Who has conferred Dada Saheb Phalke Award 2019, which is the country's highest film honor? And the answer is, it's Amitabh Bachchan. So this is the country's highest film honor. So Dada Saheb Phalke Award was introduced in the year 1969, and it is given to commemorate the father of Indian cinema. So who is the father of Indian cinema? It's Dhundiraj Govind Phalke. Dhundiraj Govind Phalke. So based upon his name, they are giving this award. Now the next question. The 16th Global SME Business Summit 2019 was held in which city? And it was held in New Delhi. Now the next question, who received the first Gauri Lankesh Memorial Award in Bangalore? And the answer here is, it's Ravish Kumar. Who appointed as the Managing Director and CEO of Federal Bank? And the answer here is, it's Shyam Srinivasan. Now the next question, who won the Formula One Singapore Airlines, that is Singapore Grand Prix 2019, held at Marina Bay Street Circuit, Singapore? And the answer here is, it's Sebastian Vettel. Now the next question, who won the 2019 FIFA Women's Player of the Year Award? And the answer here is, it's Megan Rapinoe. Now the next question, who is the winner of the 2019 FIFA Men's Player of the Year Award? And answer is, it's Lionel Messi. Now the next question, which Indian state has won 3 awards in Pacific Asia Travel Association, that is SPATA Awards for the year 2019, that was held in Nur Sultan of Kazakhstan? And the answer here is, it's Kerala. Now the next question, the first tri-services exercise code named Tiger Trump between India and which country is set to hold at Visakhapatnam and Kakinada in November of this year? And the answer here is, it's USA. And this is for the first time the US and India will be holding this tri-service military exercise. Now the next question, the United Nations observe DAS every year as the International Day for the Total Elimination of Nuclear Weapons. And the answer here is, it's on 26th of September. And this is all about to educate the public and their leaders about the real benefits of eliminating such weapons and social and economic costs. So where is the headquarters of United Nations? It's New York. And it was established in the year 1949. And who is the Secretary General of United Nations? It's Antonio Guterres, and he belongs to Portugal. Now the next question. Every year the World Maritime Day is observed on DAS, and it is observed on 26th of September. And this year the theme of this day is empowering women in the maritime community. Now the next question here, tourism and jobs, a better future for all is the theme of 2019 World Tourism Day. So which is celebrated every year on DAS, and it is celebrated every year on 27th of September. And the theme of this tourism day is tourism and jobs, a better future for all. Now the next question, the first edition of Ayushman Bharat Divas was celebrated on which day? And it was celebrated on 23rd of September. Now the next question, World Environmental Health Day observed on which day? And it is observed on 26th of September. Next question, International Day for Universal Access to Information was observed on DAS. It is observed on 28th of September. And what is the theme of this year's celebration? Leaving no one behind. This is the theme of this year's celebration. Now the next question, the World Health Organization observes World Rabies Day on DAS every year. And the answer here is, it is on 28th of September. So where is the headquarters of WHO? It is in Geneva of Switzerland. And who is the Director General? It's Tedros Adhanom. Now the next question, United Nations observes International Translation Day on DAS. And it is observed on 30th of September. Now the next question, World Heart Day was observed annually on DAS across the world. And the answer here is, it is observed on 29th of September. Now the next question, the International Coastal Cleanup Day is celebrated annually on which day of September? And it is celebrated on the third Saturday of September. And with this question, we have come to the end of the session. We covered all the important bits from the month of September. We'll meet next week with some other important current affairs. Stay tuned. Thank you.